Hello everyone, I'm Professor Lee of Dr. Anti-Aging and Herbal Medicine TV. The current special lecture on anti-aging treatment is being conducted with 12 major topics. Among them, we have studied 1. DNA damage and repair management, and 2. Telomere management. Starting today, we'll be studying the removal of senescent cells that spread aging. To summarize the key points so far, 1. Aerobic exercise or high-intensity interval training in combination with strength training. 2. 7 to 9 hours of sleep a day. 3. Stress management such as meditation. 4. Reduce calories by 10 to 25% or intermittent fasting. 5. Green tea. 6. Stragalus root tea. And if you want to manage it more actively, get guidance from a specialist and take NAD supplement. 8. Take TA65 or cycloestradiol. Now, let's start studying today's topic, senescent cells. Do you know how many cells in our body die every day? About 50 million? Or maybe 1 billion? No, about 50 billion cells die every day. When old cells die, it's called apoptosis. Today, about 50 billion cells die, but we do not feel this. This is because it is a small number compared to the number of tens of trillions of cells, and the cells that die are refreshed by new cells. It's not a bad thing for cells that are severely damaged or have reached the end of their lifespan to die. The process of replacing dead cells with new cells is necessary for the body to continue to stay healthy, and most of the dead cells are recycled. However, among the cells that should age and die, there are cells that do not die and survive. Senescent cells are cells that have stopped dividing and cannot grow, and cells that have lost their ability to proliferate, but are still alive and not dying. The reason senescent cells do not die and live is because they have a switch that turns on that prevents them from dying. Apoptotic cell and senescent cell are cells that everyone has in their bodies, but they are different. Apoptotic cells die, quietly disappear, are recycled, and induce regeneration of new tissues. However, senescent cells do not die, but maintain their metabolic activity while causing inflammation and aging the surroundings. Therefore, they are the main cause of tissue aging and create an environment in which cancer cells can develop. However, why are cells divided into cases in which they die or become senescent when they have a problem that prevents them from functioning well? Cells die quickly when they are seriously damaged beyond recovery, or when their programmed lifespan has expired and are usually removed in about a day. However, in case of moderate damage, oxidative stress, or inflammatory damage, they do not die, but instead gradually stop growing over several days to several weeks. The reason cells turn into senescent cells is not simply because they are old, but as a kind of defense program to protect themselves and the entire tissue in response to damage or stress. In other words, when they judge that they are likely to turn into cancer cells or dangerous cells with serious dysfunction in the future, senescent cells are cells that stop dividing on their own to prevent such a thing from happening. Senescent cells are not actually selfish cells that try to survive on their own. Rather, they ask for help from immune cells and cells that help with tissue regeneration in order to help the damaged cells or tissues recover. However, in order to gather cells that help with the tissue regeneration, they need to make their location known, so they secrete inflammatory substances. Then, immune cells find the location of senescent cells and gather there and remove unnecessary senescent cells in order to regenerate the tissue. Senescent cells that secrete inflammatory substances to make their location known in order to regenerate the tissues are called senescent-associated secretory phenotype, or SASP for short. Therefore, senescent cells are cells that sacrifice themselves by stopping their own growth so that they do not turn into cancer cells and invite immune cells to remove them. Unfortunately, however, a serious problem arises. When we are young, the number of senescent cells is small and our immune function is good. So, even if senescent cells are formed, they are usually removed well. Then, as we age, the number of senescent cells gradually increases, and the function of immune cells that should remove them gradually decreases. In our 20s and 30s, the number of senescent cells is very low. Furthermore, our immune function is good, so even if senescent cells are formed, they are usually removed. Then, from our 40s, senescent cell accumulation begins, and in our 50s, senescent cell accumulation increases significantly by tissue. After our 60s, senescent cell accumulation increases due to decreased immune function, and in our 80s, the ability to remove senescent cells decreases rapidly, accelerating aging. Senescent cells are our body's defense mechanism that prevent cancer by preventing the indiscriminate division of damaged or aged cells. But if they are not removed and accumulate, they cause inflammation in surrounding cells and accelerating aging. In addition, the accumulation of senescent cells is one of the fundamental causes of various chronic diseases and aging-related diseases such as cancer, heart disease, kidney disease, liver disease, dementia, Parkinson's disease, arthritis, cataract, and sarcopenia. And the rate at which senescent cells accumulate varies from person to person. Based on 60s, the rate of senescent cell accumulation varies from 2.5 times to 10 times for each person. This means that depending on how well you manage senescent cells, you can reduce the accumulation of senescent cells by up to 10 times. So, it's very important in aging treatment. In fact, managing and removing senescent cells well is a very important field in current and future aging treatment. What do senescent cells actually look like? I'll tell you about their shape and characteristics. This is a microscopic view of normal cells, a fibroblast that create collagen tissue. It has a long pointed shape at both ends. However, when it becomes a senescent cell, it looks different from normal cells. It grows in size, has an irregular shape, and its surface becomes rough. If you look at them together, you can clearly see the difference. The reason why the shape of senescent cells changes, first, because senescent cells continue to produce inflammatory substances, growth factors, and enzymes to send signals to the surroundings. The component inside the cell increases and grow larger. Also, the amount of waste inside the cell increases, so the number of organelles called lysosome to produce this also increases, so the cell size increases, becoming 2 to 4 times larger than normal cells. Also, the substances that form the skeleton inside the cell and keep the cell shape from changing are rearranged irregularly, making it difficult to maintain the original shape, resulting in an irregular shape. It's similar to the steel structure of an old building becoming bent due to aging. This change also affects cell mobility, making it difficult for cells to move from their original location or perform their functions. When tissue is injured, cells must move to the damaged area and participate in the tissue regeneration process, but if mobility decreases, there is a problem moving to the injured area or performing their role in the inflammatory response. Therefore, tissues with many such senescent cells have reduced regenerative power. Second, as you can see, denatured protein, repeat, DNA fragment, and various waste accumulate in the cytoplasm of senescent cells and accumulate in the form of granules. As this waste accumulate in the cytoplasm, inflammatory response increase within the cell. Third, the size of the nucleus of the cell increases because the DNA containing genetic information is damaged. Also, important proteins that maintain the stability of the nuclear membrane structure decreases, so the shape becomes abnormally deformed. Fourth, as explained in the telomere section, telomeres, which protect the ends of chromosomes, become very short in senescent cells. Therefore, they are cells that have lost their ability to divide. As you can see, senescent cells are stained blue, so they can be seen directly under a microscope. Since there is much more waste accumulate inside senescent cells than in normal cells, enzymes that process this waste increase greatly. Among these enzymes, one of the enzymes that increase greatly in senescent cells is an enzyme called beta-galactosidase, which breaks down sugar metabolite. This enzyme appears visually blue when stained, so it can be easily observed under a microscope and is used as one of the main indicators for identifying senescent cells. Here, one question arises. If they are damaged, why don't they just die and be recycled? Why do they survive instead of dying? The reason is that senescent cells are in a kind of emergency stop mode that emerged during the evolutionary process. It's a temporary measure to prevent the accumulation of DNA damage in cells and stimulation of oncogenic genes from turning them into cancer cells, so they do not die, but live. It's like a car with a broken brake that stops for a while to prevent it from running wild. Evolutionarily, senescent cells were originally created to live only temporarily and then be removed by immune cells. And when immune cells come and process them, tissue regeneration begins in the empty space. In order to let immune cells know where they are, they must live until then, right? Senescent cells are the system that maintains survival for a short time for the safety and regeneration of tissues. However, as we age, the immune cleaning system weakens, so senescent cells just remain. Since the garbage that needs to be cleaned up every now and then cannot be cleaned up, garbage that naturally promote aging accumulate. I think you have now gained a deep understanding of the recent hot issue of senescent cell removal aging treatment. Senescent cells have the characteristic of not dying and continuing to survive even though they are damaged cells. This is not simply because they are old cells, but because of sophisticated survival programs that avoid death operate inside the cells. First, senescent cells turn on death prevention genes that suppress cell death and create a shield that blocks the suicide command. It locks into survival mode. The left regenerative apoptosis inhibitor protein is a gene called BCL2, and this switch is turned on in senescent cells. In addition to senescent cells, cancer cells are cells that activate genes that prevent cells from dying. If you administer a drug that suppresses these genes in cancer cells, it will have an anti-cancer effect, right? Second, survival signals continue to come out from inside the senescent cells. These signals prevent the cell from dying and keep it alive even though it has stopped dividing. Third, the increase in substances that keep the senescent cells from dying. In order to prevent the senescent cells from turning into cancer cells, the genes of senescent cells must be inactive. To do this, a specific substance tightly surrounds the DNA of the senescent cells and make it immobile. This is called the senescent-associated heterochromatin foci of the senescent cells. This protein surrounds the DNA of the senescent cells and prevents it from turning into cancer cells, but it helps it survive by making it structurally stable. There are a lot of difficult terms, but you don't need to understand them in detail. Here's one you need to remember. Why don't senescent cells die? It's because the gene switch that doesn't die turns on. It continues to produce survival signals, and it has damaged DNA, but it's in a rigid, stable structure that prevents it from being active. You just need to understand this level. If senescent cells just quietly survive, they won't be a problem. Unfortunately, if they aren't removed right away and accumulate, they will gradually become more active and turn surrounding cells into senescent cells. Because of this characteristic of infecting aging, they are also nicknamed zombie cells. So next time, we'll study about zombie cells. We should also learn about the common characteristic of people who have a lot of senescent cells. Thank you all for your hard work, and I'll see you again next time.